You may have been hearing terms like hot press, cold press, watercolor, velvet, rag, and so on. I'm not quite sure what that means. If so, this is the video for you. Hi, my name is Leslie, and in today's video, we are going to be going over what is cotton paper. But before we do, please hit the subscribe button below to get notifications on upcoming videos for printing tips and tutorials to help you on your printing journey. And also please check out the links we will have listed below along with this video to help you learn some more. So jumping right into it, like I said, you might have heard terms like hot press, cold press, velvet rag, etc. These are all cotton paper, just references to different textures and finishes. And all cotton paper, no matter what, is considered fine art paper. And fine art paper will require a fine art printer. This means usually 13 inches is the minimum, like your Epson SureColor series, P700, 800, 900, and so on, as well as the Canon ProGraph Pro series 100, 200, 300,000, and so on. And this is because cotton is much thicker than wood pulp based paper, which is from trees. So your polar mat might be a 60 pound polar mat is around 11 mil, whereas your Aurora is closer to 18 mil. And so it's a big difference in thickness, and your smaller printers, there's no all-in-one printer, or especially not front-feeding printers. No cotton paper will ever work in a front feed like HP OfficeJet or anything like that. But even in the ones with a single sheet feed, we recommend to steer clear from the cotton because those printers are not meant for that paper. So some other aspects of cotton to keep mind of are cotton is also going to be a softer look than your wood pulp based papers like polar mat. It's gonna be not quite as vibrant, and that's because cotton, the fibers soak in the ink a little bit more, so it's a softer look, which most artists are going for. They want that look, but it is definitely gonna be different, and it won't be the same as your wood pulp based mats, and especially not the luster metallic in those paper. Very different look. So if you want to have that look, then cotton's the way to go. We also don't recommend using cotton paper if you are new to printing. Like we already said, if you have a small printer, don't use it. But if you're brand new to printing, cotton paper is not the best just to jump in with because it requires, it's one sheet at a time, whether you're using the manual feed in a printer or for like the greeting cards, you might be using the top feed. It's only one sheet at a time. This is not a paper you ever put 10 sheets in. It's not a production level where you can make 10 cards at a time and walk away. You can't walk away when you're printing on cotton paper. It's going to require you to be there on standby and make sure everything's going well. So just like you're spending this time and money on a high-end paper as you would with a painting, this is gonna be a high-end print versus like a production level print. So it's gonna take a little more effort working with it. So please keep that in mind if you're looking at cotton papers. And all of our cotton papers are mostly museum grade. We have one that's archival grade, just a step below. Archival grade for us means acid-free, lignin-free. And that would be Aurora Art White. It has optical brighteners, but it's still acid-free, lignin-free. And then museum grade means it has to be either like canvas or cotton. So all of our other cotton papers are optical brightener-free, and they match all the museum grade levels to be on that list. So I will list those out at the end of the video if you want to see the different types of cotton papers we offer. The next thing to note about cotton paper is that they are very sustainable. If you need a sustainable option in your printing and you want to be more eco-friendly, cotton paper is the way to go because they come from these cotton linters that would be disposed of when they're going through and getting cotton to make for whatever needs they need it for. There's usually this cotton linters waste. And what they do is they take this and they make paper with it. Therefore, it's less waste. So if you want a sustainable option, that's the way to go. But one thing to remember with that is that you will occasionally see black spots in sheets of paper. And this is because it's like how recycled paper, you'll have a lot of specks because it's just, there's a lot of, it's not perfect. With cotton paper, it's not, won't be as much as recycled paper, but you'll still have those few dark spots just from the linters that are mixed in with it. So that's just the nature of it. Like I said, it's not very many sheets, but occasionally you will see that. Another thing to note about cotton though, it does create a lot of dust. Just by nature, it's more dusty than wood pulp based paper. So some ways to work to make sure your printer is going to have a longer life, we recommend getting the anti-static brush, which has very soft bristles. You just brush the top of it just to remove any dust so then it doesn't get into your printer. And also on top of that, using printer cleaning sheets. So after every box of paper, you'd want to put a printer cleaning sheet through to help gather any dust. And if you ever have issues, if you're using the top feed for greeting cards, you use a little alcohol swab to clean the feeder. That way it can grab the paper better. So just some things to keep in mind when you are buying cotton paper to have these other accessories on standby to help you with the printing process. So now for our different types of paper that we sell that are cotton, our most popular are the Aurora Art White and Natural, and these are smooth or hot press papers. Then white, just a bright white, and the natural is a natural white is the only difference. And we have those in the 250 GSM weight and the 300 GSM weight. And then the other smooth rag we have, or hot press rag, is Paladuro Smooth Rag. This one is actually considered a higher grade than the Aurora, and it's going to be a crisper finish, a little more vibrancy in that finish over the Aurora. And so if you really want to go to the highest end smooth rag, that'd be the way to go. The next paper is Paladuro Etching, which will be a cold press or watercolor paper. And so it's going to be just a textured, very thick paper if you want a textured cotton rag look. And the final paper we have is Paladuro Soft Gloss Rag, which is very unique because it has a semi-gloss finish on top of a rag paper. No resin, therefore no acidity in it, still museum grade, but it has that semi-gloss finish, which will really make your prints be vibrant and very colorful, just as if it was on a Brita paper. It's very similar to a Brita finish, so it has that dark room look to it. So this is what we have for you about cotton paper today. Again, if you have any questions or comments, please add those below and we'll answer those, or call us at 888-248-8774. And please watch our other videos and see if they might help you on your printing journey. Have a great day and happy printing.